Good morning. Welcome to St. John United Methodist Church. My name is Beth Dixon. I'm one of the staff members, and we're delighted that you're here with us in worship today on this Epiphany Sunday and the first Sunday of the new year. So happy new year. If you are worshiping with us online, we give a special welcome to you and ask if you leave a comment, let us know that you're here worshiping with us. And if you've been visiting with us and haven't filled out a visitor card, please do so. We'd love to know that you've been here. If you've recently filled out a visitor card, I have not written you a note, and I apologize. It's been a busy first week back into the new year, so thank you for being here, though. We're grateful to have you as a part of our community. We do have a late committee meeting today after church. At that meeting will be the formal handoff of the leadership from Jerry Aldridge and Pat DeLoach, who have been dedicated to our lake property and our lake ministry for many years. We're so grateful to you both. They'll be handing over that as they both step down from that position. So we just wanted to take a moment here in worship to acknowledge their time and dedication they've spent with that with a round of applause. Thank you both. And a reminder, if you're on the lake committee, you have a meeting after church today. The leadership board will be meeting in a couple of weeks on the 21st. So just a note, we always announce those in advance. Everyone is welcome to attend, and we welcome our new members of the leadership board and thank those who are rotating off for their service. This week, choir rehearsals will resume. We are not starting back to Wednesday night suppers yet. That will happen later in the spring. Or in the winter, I guess it'll still be winter, but coming next month. But we will have children's choir rehearsals at 5:30, and the chancel choir will be back rehearsing at 7 o'clock. We do have a couple of needs on our worship team. We are in need of a bread baker coordinator, which is a very easy job, and communion steward, which could certainly be one person if you'd like to do both. The communion steward helps set everything up every first Sunday of the month for communion. You're not responsible necessarily for being here every time. If you're not going to be here, you can coordinate with someone to do that, but just to make sure that the table is prepared. So if you're interested in either of those, our worship team leader is not here today, but you could see me. But Michael Young is our worship team leader, so you could see him about that. We are also looking for a new finance manager. Unfortunately, our finance manager, Mia Holmes, resigned, and so we are in need of someone to help in the office a few hours a week with our data entry and budgeting and accounting needs. So if you know someone who's looking for a part-time position, we would love to have you send them our way. The clothes closet will also be reopening this week. They took a couple of weeks off over the holidays, and so they will be back on Tuesday. If you're looking for a volunteer opportunity during the day, on Tuesdays they're open from 11 to 1. They're always looking for more volunteers. If you do not know, we have a donation station out this back door where we've got a place for you to leave clothes that you would like to donate that are in good condition. Men's, especially small men's sizes, are always the most needed item. So if you've got anything you'd like to leave there, we don't take children's clothes at this time, other than I think they still take small sizes, like up to 2T, because we just don't have the space for it. But if you've got donations, we'd love that, and also love you to participate. they are finding that with the increase in the homeless need in the area, they're seeing a lot of homeless folks come through, also giving out food there from the snack packs that we get from DCCM. So a lot of coordination going on that this church is serving great need in this community and our Mead House. So we're thankful for everyone who keeps those operations up and running. Speaking of DCCM, their next food distribution will be on Saturday the 20th at 9 o'clock. I know winter days can be hard, but we'd love you to be there if you can help volunteer. We ask volunteers to arrive at 8:30, so keep that date on your calendar, please. Speaking of calendar, we have a new flower calendar out. We want to thank Jane Baldridge for the beautiful flowers to start our new year back. If you would like to place flowers in the sanctuary in memory or in honor of someone or an event, we'd love to have you do that. You can see Angela Powell, who's our flower coordinator, and we do have a physical flower calendar now on the bulletin board beside the office, so you can sign up for that. One last announcement this morning. Jamie has asked that I announce that we will sing only the first two verses of the opening hymn. So with that, we will now begin our worship of Almighty God.
Thank you. So we have the prophetic message more fully confirmed. You will do well to be attentive to this, as a lamp shining in the dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. Let us pray. Radiant morning star, you are both guidance and mystery. Visit our rest with disturbing dreams and our journeys with strange companions. Grace us with the hospitality to open our hearts and homes to visitors filled with unfamiliar wisdom, bearing profound and unusual gifts. Amen.
Glory be to the Father. You may be seated. At this time, I invite for you to join together in prayer for the illumination of our scriptures this morning. Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you, and the wealth of nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah. All those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
The Psalter's on page 795. Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteous to the royal son. May he judge your people with righteousness. Let the mountains bear prosperity for the people, and the hills in righteousness.
May he defend the cause of the poor of the people. Give deliverance to the needy, and crush the oppressor.
May he live while the sun endures, and as long as the moon, throughout all generations.
May he be like rain that falls on the mown grass, like showers that water the earth.
In his days may righteousness flourish and peace abound, till the moon be no more.
May he have dominion from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth.
gather over this way. We have to keep the cameraman on his toes because he gets to shift the camera over here. That's kind of exciting. Okay, we have boxed up Christmas, right? Have you taken down Christmas at your house? You have? Okay, well, I thought we might start today by talking a little bit about our favorite presents. What was something you got for Christmas? You don't remember anything? How about that necklace? Did you get that necklace for Christmas? No? What did you get for Christmas? Everybody got so much stuff they can't remember anything? Who got something great for Christmas? What'd you get, Matthew? A Nintendo Switch. Wow, that's pretty exciting. How about you? Super Mario Wonder. So Christmas is a time of gift giving, right? Is Christmas over? The 12 days ended yesterday with what the church calls the Epiphany. And most people have put away their stuff, like our nativities are gone, our Christmas tree is gone, our greenery is gone. This Sunday always feels a little empty, right? But three people escaped the box this morning and made it to church. Do you see them? Look up on the piano. Who are they? The three kings have made it to church this morning, and they come from the east. That way is east. Okay? So they escaped out of the box because they wanted to come to church today. And we call them kings. We also call them wise men. We also call them the Magi, or the sages, the wise ones, but they came probably not to the manger, even though we put them in our manger scenes. They probably got to Jesus when he was a little older, but they did what? What do we remember them coming to Jesus? They offered gifts, which is part of the reason that we give gifts at Christmas time. They offered some presents to Jesus, okay? And their presents were very symbolic, and we won't get into all that because the adults need to discuss some stuff that the kids don't need to discuss. But the three kings, or the wise ones, came to Jesus with presents. And presents and presents, do you hear the difference in those two words? If I say to you, I want a present, what do I want? A gift. If I say, I want your presence, what does that mean? I want you to be there, to be with me. Okay? So I want to tell you this morning that one of the things that the wise ones offer is to remind us to bring our presence to Jesus. So this year, I really want your presence here at church as many Sundays as you can. Because you are such a gift to us, okay? See, look at these people out there. Some of them have gray hair and some of them walk real slow, okay? And they may have trouble getting around and they may moan when they get up and down. Some of them have been talking to me about how good it is that I can bounce out of the floor after the children's sermon. Okay, so I want you to give your presence, your person, bringing your person to church so that we can celebrate Jesus. Now, having said that, Mr. Jeff has to tell you, I'm not going to be here next Sunday or the next Sunday because I have a friend that's sick in France, and I am going to offer my presence to her, to be with her in a time of need. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Loving God, I thank you for the children in my church. They are all gifts to us. I ask that you bless them this year, and I ask, God, that they come each week and offer their presence to you. Bless them, keep them safe, nourish them, and let them grow in love. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Excuse me. As you're able, please stand for a reading from the gospel. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophets. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
This morning, we have two different locations. The little town of Bethlehem, the one we love to sing about, and the court and the home of King Herod. We don't sing songs about King Herod. In that little town, there was a beautiful star. And men, we are told from the east, Magi, they heard and saw and discussed this star, and they knew that it would mark something important, something to do with God, and so they went. And they traveled. But they didn't go directly to where the star was. Instead, they go into Jerusalem. Straight to the living at that moment king of the people of Judea, the people of Israel, Herod, who built beautiful buildings, who expanded the temple to greatness, who could tell the people we need a new mountain, and a new mountain was built. He was brutal. He was known by all. So they go by his place first, wanting to know what he knows about this star. Why wasn't the baby born there? Why is God's star in Bethlehem? So they have this conversation with Herod, and then they get back in their group and they head to Bethlehem, where they go and they stand under the star and they see the house where the child is, and they are filled with joy, and they go into the house. And what a scene that must have been to have Mary and Joseph and the baby, everything they were looking for right in front of them in that moment. It had to be exciting and overwhelming. There was joy. There was a family, there was a precious baby, there were a treasure chest of gifts. It has it all in the Gospel of Matthew. See, the Gospel of Matthew overall is a pretty localized gospel that just follows with the Gospel of Mark, the places and the people that Jesus interacts with. Everyone in small communities, there's a family connection. But Matthew begins, right, with this lineage of who Jesus' family tree is. And if you want to look that up, you see that there are some interesting, unexpected people who are included into that family tree. And then you have this story of people who are not at all part of this community, who have no connection to Mary and Joseph or even to Herod, who show up. Far away travelers and visitors who make their way there. And we call this Epiphany. God is present, whether we know it or not. Love is present, whether we know it or not. And Matthew takes us and just pushes us into this unexpected space. Growing up, I knew that in my town there were maybe like 25 people who were Catholic. Small group, their priest came on like an itinerant basis, and we would get out of the Methodist church, and the little Catholic congregation at that time was right on the corner beside us, and they would always have a lovely picnic whenever the priest was there. It looked like a lot of fun. And then behind us were the group of Presbyterians. They were in the beautiful old white church. It's where I had my pre-K graduation and sang about brushing my teeth. And then down the road was the big Baptist church, First Baptist. Lots of people went there. And the Methodists kind of sat in the middle of town. Growing up, you really didn't do a lot with each group. Now, you couldn't escape First Baptist because they had like roller skating trips, and they did a lot of fun things. But besides that, you know, you kind of keep to your own little circle when it comes to church. I don't think I ever once, when the Catholic congregation was just a block away, ever walked into that sanctuary. Not one time. So we had this tight circle of faith. No one really crossing any boundaries. Man, what does God think of that? That in this story of Jesus' birth, that the Gospel of Matthew, out of all the Gospels, it just tells it as plainly as he can about who Jesus was and who Jesus is and who we are as disciples, throws in a wider circle. Epiphany is love, knowing that love is present. Love is with us. And it pushes us to expand our circles and our relationships just a little bit wider. Now that occurs first by loving and knowing we are loved by God and loving actually ourselves. For us to love others, we have to first know and know deep down that we are loved by God, and we experience and express and have a connection to that love. That helps in this. Next is finding the ways to love our family, those who are closer in our circle. Then the circle expands, and it's loving the people that we sit in church with within our own body. Then the circle expands, and it's loving those who are outside of the walls of the church, who maybe have even their own place where they sit on Sunday morning, whether it's at a coffee shop or in another building for worship. It expands a little more. But it all begins with knowing that God doesn't have a limited circle on love, but that God makes it clear that Epiphany is God is with us, love is present, and that we just have to live in that love and then learn that that love is greater and bigger than what we expect. This morning, as I was listening to the Pray As You Go podcast, if you follow the lectionary, it's a lovely podcast. It ended with today's message on the Epiphany and reading of the scripture with Jeff's children's sermon, basically. Were you listening to that, Jeff?
I was not.
It ended with, your presence is your present. What will you bring into this year? Now that you have this message before you of love that comes through Christmas, that is symbolized by a star, that is present in gifts and magi and a baby and parents and even a terrible king, what is your present? Is it your presence within the body of Christ? Is it pushing love in a new way? Is it expanding that circle of how and who you love in your life?
Too often, it is easy to keep the circle close, to keep love close, to not push the boundaries of when it comes to God's love for us and for our neighbors. So on this day of are you sitting with King Herod in the most beautiful palace in all of the land when these wise men show up? Are you sitting in the house with Mary and Joseph?
Trying to figure out, is what they're telling you really going on, and who are these strange visitors? Are you someone from the east who God is pushing you to come and to see something new? In the week ahead, where do you find yourself in this story? For love is here. God is here. The presence of God is amongst us. We begin this new year in 2024, knowing that in Bethlehem a baby was born, knowing that Mary and Joseph were parents who were just as confused as all parents, knowing there was a king who had other ideas of what power was all about, and knowing that the star showed the way of God's presence within us. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Page 881 in your hymnal. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. Even the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Maybe seated.
Christ our Lord invites us to his table, all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. I invite you to rise and exchange signs of peace with one another.
Peace. I invite our ushers to come forward with our morning's offering. May our gifts today go to the work of God's good kingdom.
Thank you.
You may be seated. I invite for you to follow along for the Great Thanksgiving on page 18 in your hymnal. I will be reading the Great Thanksgiving for Epiphany and the New Year, so some of the words will be a little different, but what your responses will be the same. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Before the mountains were brought forth and you had formed the earth from everlasting to everlasting, you alone are God. You created light out of darkness and brought forth light, life on this earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn. And blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, in whom you have revealed yourself, our light and our salvation. You sent a star to guide wise men to where the Christ was born. And in your signs and witness, and in every age and through all the world, you have led your people from far places to his light. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, telling them, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as with the confidence of God's children, let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. As we prepare for communion this morning, remember this is the Lord's table. All are invited, of young and of old, to receive the Lord's Supper. Will those assisting with communion please come forward at this time?
O God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the spirit of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now in the grace, peace, and love of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.